About 2 years ago, I reviewed The Toxic Avenger, and it was pretty much the only video people have watched. Well, it's been about 2 years, and since then I've gotten married and I've had a newborn baby daughter, and here I am still writing and doing reviews. Well, an interesting thing happened the other day while I was cruising the internet and looking up free porn. I came across this headline. The Toxic Twins, Toxic Avenger 5. Do I really have to comment? The movie has been officially announced by Troma president Uncle Lloyd Kaufman, fresh off of his recent masterpiece, Poultrygeist, Night of the Chicken Dead. Now, I can't review this film fairly, they've not even started shooting yet, but come on, given the downhill decline of these films, do you really expect it to be any good? I mean, must they really waste all this pristine, quality 35mm film on this garbage? Troma hasn't really made a watchable film since Terra Firma, and even with that, you have to really be attuned to Troma's ways to like that film. Citizen Toxie was such a horrible shitfest, and I mean that literally given all the depictions of poop flying on the screen, that this was one sequel I may have to actually run from. It makes me shudder just thinking about it.
Here's a brief synopsis according to Wikipedia. Taking place after Citizen Toxie, the Toxic Avenger and his wife have a set of mutant twins. As Melvin ages, he has to deal with his wife's menstruation, his erectile dysfunction, in this case a non-stop erection, I can't wait to see that, and a rebellious son. We also get to see these two wretched little hellhounds in kindergarten. How cute! Okay, seriously, that's like making a Batman movie about a Batman hanging up his tights so he can have kids. And no, you shouldn't take any of these film offerings as seriously as a major studio picture, but I mean, come on, why must Troma sink even lower than they've already sunk? The first Toxic Avenger came out in 1984, and it remains a cult classic. It truly is a movie that's so bad it's great. The acting is purposefully bad, the story is insane, and the effects really aren't that good. They're not terrible, but they beg to have Tom Savini's touch. For God's sakes, the main character is a mutant superhero who walks around in a tutu. It's fucking retarded. But for all intents and purposes, it's entertaining as hell. It's funny in a really dumb way, and the monster actually turns out to be a good guy. We can actually relate to him. I can't explain this movie's appeal. It's not really horror, it's not really comedy, and it tries to throw in some romance. Jason and Freddy never had love interests. This is a classic, and that's all I have to say. Now, even Troma fans detest the sequels. They have virtually nothing to do with the original, the entire cast, and even some of the character names, are different, and the makeup just got worse. In Toxic Avenger 2, Melvin fails to stop Apocalypse, an evil conglomerate, from blowing up the Center for the Blind. To escape his depression, he goes on an odyssey to find his long-lost father, who resides in Japan. This is actually a setup by Apocalypse so they can get rid of Toxie and rule Tromaville. It's heavy on gags, making it appear as a more kid-friendly film if not for all the pointless nudity. Given that the movie actually has Melvin going on a quest, and to Japan of all places, gives it some nice production value, but it's such a different kind of film that you really have to be in the right state of mind to enjoy it. The first movie was so brutal and violent that you forgave the stupidity. The sequel almost insults our intelligence by dumbing down the violence and making the cast more ditzy than before. Personally, I kind of like it, but they really should have stopped here. Last Temptation of Toxie is where the series started to take it up the ass. Toxies 2 and 3 were shot as one movie, but the final cut was nearly 4 hours long. Lloyd made the decision to release it as two separate films. But what I think happened was for whatever reason they didn't cut it right down the middle. They must have shifted certain scenes around because a lot of things that happened in Part 3 don't make any fucking sense. In Part 3, Melvin agrees to work for Apocalypse as a spokesman so that he can afford an eye operation for his blind girlfriend. But after fighting Apocalypse in Part 2, why in God's name would he work for them now? Even if they're offering him all this money, it makes no sense given that they butchered a bunch of people from his hometown. And I don't buy that this movie is a prequel either. For some reason, I can't fathom that Troma thinks that far ahead. Now, this one does go overboard with violence here, and there actually is a very biblical kind of story. Melvin actually goes up against the devil, and the story is more about monster versus monster. Melvin sells his soul to the devil, blind to all the consequences going on around him, and now has to gain back everyone's trust. By the time we get to the end, all intelligence has gone out the window, so with three, you really need to be in the right mindset. So smoke about 10 joints, inhale a nice bag of crack, and enjoy. Citizen Toxie came out about 12 years later, and as I mentioned, it sucks. What sucks about it is, you could kind of say they were trying before. This one just seemed like a bunch of drug addicts got together, threw in a bunch of random, unrelated ideas, and made a movie bearing the title Toxic Avenger. It's borderline porn. In this one, Toxie has a sidekick, played by Troma alumni Joe Fleischacher, named Lardass. While attempting to save the Tromaville school for the very special from the Diaper Mafia, the bad guys set off a bomb that throws Toxie into a parallel dimension. While Melvin is sent to Amortville, his evil doppelganger Noxie is sent to Tromaville, and now they have to get back to the proper dimension. At this point, the acting is just plain bad. It doesn't even make you laugh. It's almost like watching people make fun of retarded kids. No one took their work very seriously, the effects all looked really cheap and rushed, and as far as Toxie's makeup goes, I appreciate that they tried to go back to the style of the first Toxic Avenger film, but it just doesn't look right. It looks like cheap plastic. Admittedly, it's kind of fun to see him come back after 12 years, but nothing looks authentic. Also, the story just gets too far out of hand and the gags are just extremely gross. Their idea of funny in this one is having old ladies shit themselves, old men running around bare-assed in a hospital, getting stabbed with multiple hypodermic needles filled with AIDS.
Oh, now I've got AIDS!
There's nothing that pleases about this film. I'm sorry if I'm being such a prude with this one, but it really makes you want to vomit. The whole movie is just plain gross. It's hard to sit through a lot of it. Now there's Toxic Avenger 5. What else is there to say? I consider myself a filmmaker. I haven't done much, but I do believe in the artistic spirit. And the artistic spirit, in most cases, should be beautiful. Then again, sometimes you make something like Toxic Avenger, and in the first case, it worked. But Troma really started to push the envelope as far as what they could show on the screen. I think they would be far more recognizable if they stopped trying to gross people out and just tried to make a decent movie for a change. No one wants to see people smelling someone else's asshole, people drinking semen or poop, deaf girls with rotted gums being cornholed by plastic mutants, people eating skin, or giant mutated penises.
Well, actually that last one might be cool, but the rest of it needs to really go away. This is a message, my friend. This is a message for you. Lloyd, you can make all the sequels you want to this goddamn franchise, but if you're gonna do it, make it good. Make it good, my friend. Make it good!